wish you a pleasant day, my dear students. Let's study English. In the previous class, we discussed about the gift of temples, its first part, in which Mridu, a little girl, with her grandmother or with Tappi, went to her aunt's home and Rukumini's home and met her children, Ravi, Lalli, and Meena. And they were making a lot of mischiefs. They were feeding a kitten, and we had seen many interesting incidents in the first part of the lesson. Children, let's move on to the second part of the lesson, a gift of chappals. All the students, you should take page number 22 and keep your fingers over the line where I'm reading. Mridu crept up to the window. Lalli was sitting a little distance away. Children, and you know, when these children were playing with kitten, and while Ravi was talking a lot about Mahendran, they heard a loud voice, a loud noise, and they upset, you know. So, on hearing that sound, Mridu crept up to the window. That means the sound was coming from through the window, so that she crept. That means slowly, slowly moved up to the window. What did she see there? Lalli was sitting a little distance away, awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring, her elbows jutting out and her eyes glazed with concentration. My dear students, you please look at that picture. You will be able to see how Lalli, the little girl, is holding the violin in her hand. She was sitting awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring. Bowstring means it is the string of the violin. And she was playing the violin. But the way she is holding the violin is not good. And how she is sitting, her elbows jutting out and her eyes glazed with concentration. Her elbows were jutting out. That means it is out of the position. And she is glazed with the concentration. That means the master is teaching her how to play violin. So she was observing carefully. In front of her, with most of his back to the window, was the bony figure of the music master. Bony figure means he was a skeleton. A skeleton person. He is the music master. Look at the picture and you will be able to see how the music master is sitting. The music master is sitting his back towards the wall. He had a mostly bald head with a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears and an old-fashioned tuft. That means you might have seen this in olden days. The Brahmins and other peoples were looking just like this. And the writer is explaining about his appearance. How is his head? His head is a bald head. That means bald head means a head without hair. And a few hairs only were present in the head. How are these hairs looking? And he had a most bald head with a fringe of old black hair falling around his ears and an old-fashioned tuft. See, you will be able to see the curly black hairs are falling near to his ear and it is just like making a tuft. A gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck and a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it glided up and down the stem of the violin. So, he was wearing a gold chain in his neck. How was his neck? His neck looks leathery. Okay? And a diamond ring glittered on his hand. His hand on in his finger, he wore a diamond ring which was glittering and on his a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it down the stem of the violin, and while he was playing the stem of the violin, this diamond ring was glittering. A large foot stuck out from beneath his gold bordered vesti edge, and he was beating time on the floor with a scrawny big toe. Can you see that man is sitting on the floor and his toe, his big toe, his big leg is moving out of his vesti. Vesti, what's the meaning vesti? Vesti means dhoti. That means in Malayalam it is mundu. So the vesti, it has a golden bordered edge, and beneath his gold bordered vesti edge, he was beating time on the floor with the scrawny big toe. You will be able to see the scrawny big toe of the leg beneath the vesti in the picture. So what he was doing with the leg? He was beating time. That means he was making rhythm for the music. And children, look and listen. He played a few notes. Lally stumbled behind him on her violin, which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hands. Since she was a beginner, she was trying to learn this violin, she looked unhappy. Lally stumbled behind him on her violin. That means while the master was playing violin, then following his music, the Lally also was playing her violin, but it looks very unpleasant. What a difference! The writer is explaining about the way the Lally, the master plays the violin and how Lally plays. Listen. The music master's notes seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the invisible tracks of the melody. That means while the master was playing violin, it was so sweet and it was very melodious. It was like the wheels of a train fitting smoothly into the rails and whizzing along. And you know, whenever a train moves along the rails, it makes a sound, but it looks very smooth. Its running is very smooth. How it looks whenever the master plays violin, it looks just like this. It was a train fitting smoothly on the into the rails without and whizzing along. As Ravi said, Mrudu stared at that huge, bearded hand moving effortlessly up the violin stem, making lovely music. So Mrudu could see that this man is with his bearded hand, means he is wearing a ring in his hand. So it is said the bearded hand. So Mrudu stared at that huge bearded hand moving effortlessly up the violin stem, making lovely music. And Mrudu was amazed how this music master is effortlessly, very smoothly he was playing this violin. Strack! There was Lally derailing again. That means whenever the master plays music, this girl is stumbling. Stumbling means she is following by making little stoppings. This is what stumbling. So at that time, after the master finishes his playing, she starts to play the violin so that it makes a squeak. Then Ravi telling, there was Lally derailing again. Derailing means the train is, the wheels of the train is moving out of the rail. That is derailing. Amma, came a wail from the gate. Wail means it is the sad cry of a man. That is Amma. Amma, oh, Ravi, send that beggar away. That means on hearing the sound, we will be able to understand that that Amma sound is the sound made by a beggar. So on hearing the sound of the beggar, the mother is telling to Ravi, "Ravi, send that beggar away," cried his mother from the back veranda. And she was, where was she? She was in the back veranda. What was she doing? Where she was chatting with the Tappi. And whenever she was chatting with the Tappi, she could hear the sound of the beggar. At that time, she cried, means she shouted in a loud voice, "Ravi, send that beggar away. He has been coming here every day for the past week. And each time he found another house to beg from." Party explained it to Tappi. And by the time, this party was telling to Tappi that this man was coming here to beg something, and it is 1 week already spent here, and now he can find, why couldn't he find another way, another home to beg from?